एंड द कंपेनियन इन स्पाइट ऑफ द वायलेंस इन स्पाइट ऑफ द एक्ट ऑफ ब्रुटैलिटी इन स्पाइट ऑफ द एक्ट ऑफ किलिंग मैसेकर किलिंग विच वर बींग डन बाई द डिसबिलीवर्स द क्रिमिनल्स ऑफ मक्का अगेंस्ट मुस्लिम दे वर पेशेंट and they were not allowed to take up the arms just to save their own life. There was no permission of defensive war. Even at that time, five commandments of jihad were revealed in Holy Quran. My dear brothers and sisters, I just want to mention so that you may make mental notes. It is Surah Al-Furqan, verse number 52. फला तो तेल काफिरीन वजाहिदहुम बिही जिहादन कबीरा दिस वर्स वाज रिवील्ड इन मक्का मन जाहद फइन्नमा युजाहिदु लिनफ्सि दिस वाज रिवील्ड इन मक्का वल्लजीन जाहदु फीना लनहदियन्नहुम सुबुलना दिस वाज रिवील्ड इन मक्का फाइव वर्सेस कमांड कंटेनिंग द कमांडमेंट्स ऑफ जिहाद वर रिवील्ड इन मक्का दिस फैक्ट explains the reality and differentiates the percept between perception and reality that concept of jihad is a broad based concept it is a broad based human struggle it can be a religious struggle it can be a moral struggle it can be a spiritual struggle it can be an educational struggle it can be a struggle for charity for the better of mankind for the better of being for the better of God for the better to upgrade the oppressed people to protect them from any kind of violence so this is a broad based concept and educationally the reasoning is ijtihad intellectual effort so this concept given in Holy Quran this is a broad based concept and it is not confined to the act of lawful warfare now I am coming to the kinds of jihad there are five dimensions of the concept of jihad one is spiritual dimension we are confused and we have confined and we have made the concept of jihad very narrow lawful war is a single one dimension of the broader concept of jihad in the same way as ibadah when we hear the word ibadah we consider an act of prayer or fasting but no ibadah is a comprehensive concept any act of modesty any act of purity any act of humbleness any act of renunciation any act of charity any act of piety any act of humility any act which is in the betterment for the people for the sake of Allah is known as ibadah in the same way jihad has five dimensions one is the spiritual dimension second is academic dimension third is social dimension fourth is political dimension and fifth is defensive dimension why we are neglecting four basic dimensions of the concept of jihad and we are emphasizing just on a single dimension by spiritual dimension holy prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated jihad means he said al mujahidu man jahada bi nafsi A man who fights against his lower self to control wrong negative wishes propensities and to develop his morality to develop his spirituality to develop his humanity to develop the spiritual condition the spiritual state of his life so this tazkiya self purification this mujahada which the sufiya the awliya have been doing throughout the history of Islam this is known as the biggest jihad of Islam remember it is narrated in sahih hadith related by imam tirmizi holy prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said He was asked, who is Mujahid, Ya Rasulullah? Holy Prophet said, Al Mujahidu man jahada bi nafsi. Mujahid is the one who fights against his lower self and who tries to protect his human and spiritual and moral and ethical qualities in his life through process of self-purification. Holy Prophet was coming back from a lawful war along with his companions, and he said at that time to his companion, addressed them, and he said, Rajana min al jihad al asghar ila al jihad al akbar wa qalu mal jihad al akbar ya Rasulullah. Qala jihad al nafs. Holy Prophet said, we are coming back from smaller jihad and we are returning towards a greater jihad, bigger jihad. Companions asked, Ya Rasulullah, which one is the bigger and greater jihad? He said, to fight the wrong wishes and desires of your lower self and to improve your spirituality and morality in a way that your life becomes beneficial for the whole of mankind. This is the greater jihad. In the same way, second dimension is educational, academic jihad bil ilm, to spread the knowledge and to fight against ignorance and to fight against illiteracy and to spread the knowledge and to work for knowledge, establishing the university, colleges, schools, and provide ilm to every single person of society. This struggle is known as al jihad bil ilm. The third is jihad bil mal, any act of charity in order to alleviate the poverty. You spend your money, your wealth, your property, your earning to resolve the deadlock of the poor people, to help the orphans of the society, to help the poor of the society, to help the depressed classes of the society. So these kinds of acts of charity, according to Islam, is known as jihad bil mal. And the last dimension, and again the political dimension of jihad, is Holy Prophet said, afdalul jihad kalimatu haqqin inda sultanin jairin. The best jihad is if you say a truthful word in front of a corrupt ruler, in front of a cruel ruler, in front of a dictator. If you stand up, this is a political reformation, and you say the truthful words, it means you are committing a jihad. So jihad is a peaceful political process. Jihad is a peaceful educational process, advancement. Jihad is a peaceful process of charity, is a peaceful process of social reform, and is a peaceful process of spiritual uplifting. And the last dimension is the defensive dimension. And defensive dimension means that if you are attacked, somebody attacks on you, so you are allowed, according to the UNO Charter, according to international laws of the present world, according to the laws of human rights, every single nation member of UNO has a right of self-defense. If your faith is attacked on, if your land is attacked, if your life is under attack, you can stand up, but not you. State, this is responsibility of the state, responsibility of the government, responsibility of the political authority to stand up and fight in your self-defense, to defend your land, to defend your faith, to defend your country, to defend your people. So jihad bil qital is only reserved for defensive war, and that is lawful war as it is provided in the Charter of United Nations. But keep in your mind, in spite of this fact, in spite of this fact, Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave specific instructions, and specific instruction given by Holy Prophet were